these are things that are topical to every single person. They're sort of universal throughout humankind. You know, they're specific. The things that I'm talking about are specific, but they're applicable to everybody and to everybody's interpretation. Urban Folklore is my 9th album on Origin Records, and it features the great rhythm section of Orrin Evans on piano, Donald Edwards on drums, and Eric Revis on bass. The concept behind this album in particular was to try to take the trumpet quartet format, you know, trumpet, piano, bass, and drums, and to sort of explore some of the storytelling that goes on in our modern society. Humanity has always used storytelling as a means to sort of alleviate stress and share and sort of get to know people. And there's a lot of sort of themes and stories that I hear people telling and that sort of make up our modern folklore. I first met Orrin Evans at a jazz festival in Idaho a few years back, and Matt Jorgensen and I had an opportunity to play with him. And we were both like, we gotta get this guy out to Seattle. And so since then, we've sort of tried to keep the relationship going back and forth. I first met Donald Edwards in my own house, as a matter of fact. I was living in a house with a bunch of musicians, and I came home from a gig, and he was in my living room playing the you-know-what out of the drums. Revis used to come through Seattle and play for a week with Branford. We used to hang at the Jazz Alley condos, and it was great to get to know him, and he was very encouraging. He was like, man, when you come to New York, look me up. And at that time, he was still living in New York when I moved there, and I would see him, and we would hang a little bit and just try to keep the personal relationship going. And this is one of the first few times, when we recorded this, this is one of the first opportunities I've had to play with him in public. A good example of sort of one of the stories we all kind of have and share is one of the songs is called The Tale of Debauchery, because everybody has a story about that one time they did that one thing where they maybe crossed the line a little too far. The Washington Generals is one of my favorite tunes on the record. The Washington Generals are the team that constantly played against the Harlem Globetrotters, and so pretty much every game, and they're all exhibition games, they lost. And so these guys would get up in the morning, get ready to go to work, put their sneakers on, and go play the game, knowing that they were going to lose, and lose bad. Just like the Globetrotters would know that they were going to do the same thing, and they were going to win every game. It has to be about something more than just winning and losing. You know, when they go out and play the game, for people to see, it's about fun and entertainment and enthusiasm and expertise and finesse and all those kinds of things. And I sort of feel like, well, if the actual generals in Washington, you know, took the opinion that it wasn't about winning and losing, we would be in a better space too, you know. The job of a musician is to sort of illustrate the human condition and all of its ways, and sort of try to prop that up and try to help people get on with their day. And that we all observe society around us, and we can choose to comment on it or not. Sometimes music can be a much more powerful tool to sort of make that kind of commentary. I think Donald and Orrin and Eric all bring a lot of expertise, a lot of honesty, a lot of conviction to the music. This record is really about the listener. It's about you, because these are all things that pertain to you. So I hope people get a chance to sit back and take a listen to it with an open mind and realize that this is not something that just is abstractly out there. This is actually about us, about all of us. The music on this record is about everyone. all have a tale of debauchery about that one time we took it too far. I don't know anybody that doesn't have one of those. Even my priest.